Hello there, everybody. Waddles here. Today, I am going to show you how to make an explosively fiery, cool, easy, simple blaze farm. We're gonna make a really cool grinder out of this thing. I'm not claiming to be the first one to use this design, but this is going to be pretty easy to make. Honestly, I can make this much easier than a skeleton grinder or something like that. I struggle with those a lot, and this one, aside from the first step, is gonna be pretty easy for you. Now, the wonderful thing about this design is that it is going to be easy to make, and it's gonna work anywhere on any version of this game. As long as you've got blazes in the game, as long as you've got sticky pistons in the game, it's going to work. This will even work on the frying pan, maybe, that you are playing this game on nowadays. So all I ask of you is that if this helps you out, leave a like and maybe even subscribe. I've got a few other tutorials on this channel that would definitely be useful for you if you're trying to learn how to build some different new cool things. So with all of that being said, I think it's time for me to show you exactly what you need to build this farm. Looks like a lot, but really, trust me, it's not that much. What do you need to collect to make this blaze farm? Obviously, you would need a blaze spawner. Then you need 36 sticky pistons, plus 28 more if you want to add the addition that I'm going to talk about at the end of this tutorial. So get at least 36 sticky pistons. You could come back and get these after if you want, but then 36 stone pressure plates. I recommend stone. You could use wood though if you really want to use wood pressure plates, but 36. Then you need 12 repeaters and 24 redstone dust. Those amounts are going to change if we talk about what we're going to talk about at the end, but this side of the chest is what you really need. Then you need building blocks. So really not that much. Get this stuff, then we can move on to the next step, which is building the thing. For your convenience, I will throw timestamps in the description for this part of the video. Look down there if you lose your place. So step one, as it always is with any of these grinder designs or tutorials that I do, is finding a blaze spawner. We have to go into the nether and go into a fort and find a blaze spawner. So conveniently, I've actually run into one right up here. Now, ideally for these blaze spawners, you want one in a room like this. So I found the perfect one already. They can spawn over a lava ocean, which is doable. It'll work. It's still a spawner. But ideally, to make it easier for you and your making of this grinder, find one of these. Look through your whole fort and find one of these, and then I recommend set up a little workstation out here, like crafting table, furnace, that kind of stuff, and do a doorway so the wither skeletons can't run in on you and kill you. Maybe go a little bit further away from this thing, but set up a little workstation because we are about to get to work here. So here we go. I've got my workstation set up now. Step two is the hardest step. This is the step where I would recommend maybe fire resistance potions, at least a good set of armor, or maybe a friend if you're on a server to kill off blaze while you're digging this room. But what do you need? You need to dig three up from this grinder. Go three up everywhere, and you need to go four out in every direction from the grinder. So the room's going to be centered on the grinder in here, if you can see through all this blaze. So one, two, three, four. Then back here, one, two, three, four. Over here, one, two, three, four. And then over here, it would be four. So one, two, three, four. So you go in one on this wall. You want to go three up and four out everywhere and level the floor. Obviously, other than a way so you can get in and out, leave a way in and out, but level the floor. Don't worry about the floor yet. Just fill it all in like this and dig out. Now, like I said, this is going to be the hardest step because these things will be spawning on you and trying to shoot you and all of that annoying stuff. So have patience on this step, but once you get past this step, it will be way easier. But really, just focus on getting this whole room, and honestly, it can be any block right now. You could use cobblestone and fill this room in if you're maybe getting shot at from ghasts and stuff. You're over an ocean, maybe use cobblestone and make the room out of cobble so you don't have to keep fixing things. But the room can be anything. It just needs to be the same dimensions. I switched the game over to peaceful so you don't have to listen to those annoying blaze anymore. But step one is done. We've dug the room, put three blocks connecting the spawner to the ceiling in here to prevent things from standing on top of the spawner and therefore slowing your rates down. So do that, connect it to the ceiling, fill in the floor. Now what you want to do is go underneath the floor, walk back out of the room. You can close it now if you want because things will still be spawning, and dig three down. So you see I'm right under the floor, under the room. You want to dig three down everywhere. So go to the corner, find your corner, you know, poke a hole, make sure you have the exact same corner, and clear out this whole space three down. Leave the ceiling above you because this is what is stopping the blaze from getting you. That's a little like technique that I have realized from making these farms, is if we put the ceiling or leave the ceiling above us, this gets really easy. We shouldn't have very many blazes, if any at all, falling in on us if we just leave it like that. But focus on making the same exact room three tall, same dimensions, find the same corners. When you're doing this step again, don't worry about the floor unless you have to worry about the floor. If it's over an ocean, worry about the floor. If it's over somewhere like this, you're gonna need to make a floor so you can reach things, but don't worry about the floor yet. Next step requires more digging. This is where we worry about the floor. So we're making an upside down pyramid shape to grind these things. This upside down pyramid shape is one of the most efficient ways to collect these things into a one block space so you can kill them easily. So what you want to do is create a ledge like I did around this room. I like to use nether bricks because they don't burn. Don't use netherrack, or you could use netherrack, but then you're going to have a blaze shoot something and the fire is burning forever. The center drops down. You're going to drop down three blocks. So really you have this floor and then the two blocks. You want to drop down the three blocks and dig out just the center, not underneath the ledge. Don't worry about that. Just the center blocks. Now, again, we're making an upside down pyramid shape, kind of. Now, while digging this, go ahead and fill in all of your walls in here. You want all of the walls all closed off, other than your entrance wall, of course, but you don't want this thing open to the outside or the blaze will escape. But now that we've dug down one layer of this upside down pyramid, do the same thing. Put the block ledge around just the edge, and then in the center, you're going to dig down three again. Now, another thing I should mention about this step is make sure your walls are what you want, because once you break this floor, blaze will start falling in on you. We're not breaking the floor yet, but put the design how you want it to look. If you want cobblestone in place of where I have the nether rack, do that, but do it now before you open or start the grinder. But I've dug down three again, and I have the floor up here that isn't something that's going to always stay on fire. Now you're gonna dig down three again. The design is an upside down pyramid if you haven't caught on. Oh, also, yeah, do this ledge. Do your ledge again. Always do your ledge. That's always a thing. But dig down three again and box it all in. Close it off to the outside world. So we now have this upside down pyramid. You're trapped down here, or you're not if you're smart and you just parkour out of here. But this is exactly what we should look like at this point. Easy enough. So we need to end on this 3x3 area. This gets us down into this 1x1 area that we need, which is the center of this thing. If all your measurements are correct, this block is right below where the spawner is, and my measurements are correct. So once you have this block, dig down five. Now, don't dig straight down. You could fall into lava unless you're certain that there's no lava down there. Just be very careful. But 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I have my five down. This is where they're going to fall to grind them. So then dig one more down, the sixth one, and put a block that they're going to fall on. So this will be our last step of a bunch of digging. You need to make a room for yourself to stand in to kill these things now. So I usually just kind of dig out a small area around this little block, and I would recommend to go back later and make it all fancy. We'll talk about that a little more, but this is going to be your grinding room. Dig your way back up to your workstation if you did that. Get back into that hallway, because this you want to leave pretty much closed off now, like this. The next step, the redstone step now. We slowly will begin adding the redstone in. So I go step by step. So meaning sticky pistons, then we're going to do the wiring, then we do the pressure plates last. So we have our room. Starting up here with our sticky pistons, you want to dig two back. But notice that I'm not on this first layer. This is where that varying amount comes in that we'll talk about near the end. I went down to this first layer and dug out the middle five. So just not the corner two. And you put sticky pistons lining the back, all facing inwards. And do it on every single side of the pyramid here. Now, make sure your pistons are all kind of boxed in. Like, I might not want to have them exposed on the outside, because in theory, I do believe that gas can break them. And that's kind of annoying to have to replace those. So box it all in if you want. It's up to you. But there's that. And do it on every single side of this first layer. Okay, easy enough. Jump down to the next layer. Now it's just the middle three on every side. So go back two and place them facing inwards again. Only the middle three now. Okay, so this layer's done. Now jump down to your last layer, dig back two in just the middle, and place a piston. Do it in the middle on all of these. So basically no pistons in any corners ever. That's all the pistons. That should have been your 36 pistons. What you need to do is get ready for the wiring. So grab your wiring, and what you want to do before laying the wiring is dig out the block underneath all of these sticky pistons. And notice I haven't put any blocks like the sticky piston would be pushing yet, because just don't do that yet. It'll get annoying. But dig out underneath all of the sticky pistons and make sure you have one, a block on the floor. Now this time it doesn't matter. You could have it match whatever your ledge block is, or you could leave it netherrack. It won't matter because we're going to be putting wiring on it, but make sure there's a block in front of the piston and beneath the piston everywhere. So let's see. I don't really have any examples of where there's not a block, but if there's not a block underneath the piston, put a block underneath the piston. Again, we're changing nothing to the first layer. It is redstone time. So what we're doing here is we're going to put repeaters and redstone to power the blocks underneath the sticky piston to in turn power the sticky piston. So if you do your wiring like I just did on this top one, like on the five, two repeaters, three dust, you will maximize or minimize the need of repeaters. Then if you put a lever and like you flick it, or you did one of your pressure plates to test it, it should power the piston right above it. Now notice this lever is powering the pistons below it. That's fine. It doesn't really matter that much, but you just need to make sure that you're powering all of these pistons. So copy the wiring like that there on this layer, put the repeater in the middle, two dust on the side, and on the final layer, put one dust in the middle, just like that. So copy that all the way around, wire up all of your sticky pistons, but don't put the pressure plates yet. It'll make it pretty darn tedious. That should use up all of your redstone and repeaters if you brought the exact amount. So the next step, the pressure plates, and then of course the block that the sticky pistons will push out to push the blaze off. That is what this whole setup is. Blaze will fall, but they won't necessarily move to the middle. So we're going to move them to the middle with the sticky pistons. I don't think I clarified that earlier, but the next step is actually putting the blocks in. So how I do this is I go up to that middle grinding spot and actually break into it and start to tower up. So then you throw your pressure plates down, connecting to all the redstone, and then throw a block in front of all of the sticky pistons. Tower up a little more and continue that. You need a pressure plate in front of every single redstone or repeater. So you are going to end up with something looking like this. No pressure plates in any corner. Easy as that, and no sticky pistons visible anymore. So if you stand on one of these, like if I stood here, it pushes me down and pushes me down again. Now, it just pushed me into that block. But if I had these gone and we like tested it, say here, pushes us down, land in the middle. And then if I was a blaze, I would continue falling downwards. This is how we move the blaze down into our grinding spot. The whole grinder is done now at this point. But where those extra sticky pistons come in, you could line this whole top layer with sticky pistons again, just like we did, except the corners, and it would work fine. It would probably make it even more efficient. But that is overkill to me, and I don't need to do it. But if you want, just copy this whole setup, but put it up here. So you need You need 28 more pistons and a good deal more repeaters and dust, but it's totally doable and it will increase the speed of your farm. So with all of that though, you need to knock out the center area and definitely close it off, because at this point there should be a whole lot of blaze in that top room, and we're about to break them out, let them fall down into here. My advice for doing this step is to sneak all the way over on the backside. You know, you have your exit probably leading to the fort over there. Go to the backside and slowly start breaking the blocks row by row. Hold shift. You do not want to fall down into here, because then blaze could follow right behind you, and then you have a blaze mess down there. So just slowly and carefully start punching out or digging out the floor. Try and stay on this side of the floor that you've dug out, because that will block a lot of the fireballs that the blaze are shooting at you. If I'm staying over here, the blaze would, you know, kind of float up and keep shooting while we're just digging out the floor. So do all of this, make sure your whole room is closed in. It should all still be, but if you had any gaps, like, you know, at the floor level, fill those all in. And with that, you want to go and seal this up as fast as possible. Don't get shot anymore. Now run very far away. Go back towards your portal. Go like 200 or 250 blocks away and come right back. Why do you do this? Because the blaze are targeting you right now, and that's annoying. You're gonna hear them shooting at each other and trying to shoot at you. So when you come back, it resets the spawner, resets the spawns. And so now it's time to grind. You should slowly start getting blaze down here. Now you need to make an AFK spot within range of this spawner. So that is 16 blocks. What I have found is 16 blocks for me could be right behind this piston. Right behind this piston is 16 blocks, and I can AFK here, and the spawner is active. From my experience, I do believe that the two blocks behind all of these pistons on the first layer are the closest active spots, but maybe there's a closer spot like to this grinding area that you find. But that's my little tip, is make an AFK spot behind one of these pistons, the bottom layer pistons. Swinging over to my world where this grinder is in progress, down here is not finished, but up here is. This is that bottom layer of pistons, and I've set up an area where I can kind of AFK or stand around and wait for the farm to produce the blaze and send them down to the bottom. Then I just swing on down there from a staircase and start grinding them. I recommend using a looting 3 sword, because that's the most effective way to get a bunch of blaze rod if that's what you're trying to do, but these things drop an insane amount of XP as well. Now in theory you could set up a crusher down there, which would be perfectly fine. Then you don't need to even bother swinging at them and you could kill them. Sometimes the blaze will glitch up and they will get suffocated in a block for some reason. I can't quite figure out why that is going on, but it's something that you should know. It's not a pretty frequent occurrence for me, but it does occur for me. So the key to this farm is just patience. If you have any more questions about the design, go ahead and throw them down in the comments. If I get enough or think of some improvements to this design, I could make a part 2 to this tutorial. But with all of that, that is the tutorial for this blaze grinder. I hope this works out decently. This has been Waddles. Subscribe if this helped you. Leave a like if it helped you. And I will see you next time with another tutorial, another video, another something. Thank you for watching. Go have a good day. Goodbye.